Hi, welcome back to Palm Breeze Cafe. I'm Lee Keller.
Kim Cavanaugh here talking about Picasa 2.
Yeah, it's really a wonderful program. Some of the things you've done with pictures already are just amazing.
It really is. And you know, again, you know, you don't have to settle for bad pictures when you've got digital images. And you've got a free program that will let you do things like we've seen already, cropping, color adjustments. And now we're going to take a look at a couple of other additional adjustments and then some creative things that you can do as well.
Most common problem with amateur photographers is you get that red eye.
Red eye is a killer. And speaking of killers, one of our friends here may kill us for using her photograph.
You know, she makes a lot of cookies for you, and you might not be getting cookies.
Yeah, I may not be. But I want to do her a favor because this is a pretty good picture. She's having a great hair day here. But I want to fix her red eye. And it's not really pronounced here. So I'm going to zoom in, and again, very easy. I'm going to click on the Basic Fixes tab, and then I'll click on the red eye button. And all I have to do is come over to the picture and draw a little square right over the top of the red portion of the eye.
That was it?
That's it. Apply it,
and
it's gone. Now I've got a much better picture of our friend Jan.
Wow.
That removes the red eye. Now, don't do this with pets because pets don't get red eyes. They get green eyes. I wish there was a pet red eye removal sometime. But that's a great example of how you could fix something very, very, that's a very common problem
by
just using Picasa and taking care of those kind of issues.
Now, Kim, I noticed a lot of neat buttons down at the bottom here. Can you go through those quickly?
Yeah, well, let's talk about them real quick. Down at the bottom here, this is the one that I think Picasa's trying, or Google's trying to make a little money on. It's called the Web Album.
Okay.
You can take your photographs and you can create an album of your photographs, upload them to the internet, and then share a link to them with your friends.
Okay. So it's free to a limit?
I think it's free up to a point. Now, in the school district, if you try to use this, it's not going to work.
No, because there are some pictures up there we don't want our children
right.
to be
Right. We don't know who, you know, again, it's a free service. People can put any kind of pictures. And I think Google probably polices it pretty well.
Mm-hmm.
But I don't expect that they're able to keep it entirely under control. So the web album portion from inside our school district is blocked. But, again, if you're using this at home, it's a great way to share pictures with your friends.
Email?
Email, obviously, as you would expect. If I click on that button, well, let me get a picture here that I want to
send
to someone.
Can I hit?
All right. So it will ask me, what do I want to use?
Wow.
Picasa has its own mail system that you can use, or you
Amazing.
Can use your built-in email system as well. Obviously, printing is going to allow us to print out to our printer.
And why would I order prints?
Well, and I did this, you know, I'm on a Mac. At home, and so most of my stuff, my photographs, I actually use iPhoto to manage my pictures at home, and it's very, very similar to what you get with Picasa. But check this out: this automatically links you to services where you can have your pictures printed.
Prices are right there.
Absolutely. So if I have a series of pictures and I've got a local Walmart, I can click on that button, upload my pictures to the Walmart service. And go to my local Walmart and pick them up.
Oh, that's amazing.
And there are a bunch of these services that allow you to do that. Shutterfly is one.
Even CVS.
Even CVS, Kodak.
Walgreens.
And the cool one here, and I was mentioning iPhoto before, what I did for my wife for her 50th birthday is I took a bunch of pictures and then I uploaded them and had a book printed and shipped to her. And you can do the same kind of thing with Kodak and Walgreens and Ritz and all these kind of services. Offer the same kind of thing.
Scroll up to the top.
Where is it? Okay, back to Picasa. I've got a little lost there.
These are really nice things.
So these are great. Yeah, again, so you can order prints. You can send it directly to your local drugstore. Go to the drugstore, pick up your prints, and you're all set and ready to go.
We know about blogging. What about this collage thing?
Take a look at this. And I really like this because, I got to show you one more fix first before we can do that.
Okay, you've got this picture.
We talked about the common problem with pictures is red eye. Second most common problem, you turn the camera sideways.
Yeah.
Okay, so here's a series of pictures that my daughter took for a science fair project she was doing. She was planting radishes and doing some stuff with different kind of solutions. This one is sideways, so this is really hard. Let's go ahead and turn that
to
the left, and now it's all
just
fixed.
Like that.
Now, what I want to do here is, I've only got so much room on that science board for my science project. So I want to make a collage of pictures because I want to document. I hold down the control key, and I select the pictures that I want to be part of my collage.
Mm-hmm.
And then down at the bottom of the interface, there's a big old button that says collage. So with my picture selected, I'll click on collage, and now it's going to build
a
collage of photographs. And what does it look like?
Looks like a collage.
Yeah, no, the old Polaroids. Remember the Polaroids that you used to have?
Oh, yeah, that's right, the bottom part.
Right,
there,
and you can actually make choices, and you can move these around a little bit. So maybe I want to reorder them or put one in front of the other and see how fast it takes that to do that.
Quickly.
And I have options on different things I can do. I can do a picture grid if I want to be more ordered, have things set up in a particular way like that. Or I can stick with my picture pile, and I can choose different backgrounds.
Nice.
So lots of cool little things. Now, when I'm done, all I do is I click on my Create button. It's going to create the collage, and then it's going to say, all right, there's your collage. Now I've got a whole new picture within my photo gallery here in Picasa.
And it's I can already go ahead, added it.
Yeah, and I can go ahead and I can export that out, save it, print it, do what I want to do
use
with
it
that.
In a report.
Right.
What else
so,
do we have here real quick?
Well, real quick, let's take a look.
There's a slideshow up here. What exactly
Well,
does that
let's
do?
Say I want to do a slideshow and I want to show somebody my pictures. Hey, Lee, I just went on this great bike trip. Went around the state. We're going to take a whole bunch of pictures. Let me share those with you. And I can come into my library and I just pick here and hold down shift and pick here. And I'm going to hit slideshow. And now I've got a slideshow that I can scroll through or I can just hit autoplay. And it'll run through my slideshow. So pretty cool. Yep,
cool.
It is pretty cool. And I can use this button to do something, which I don't really know. but it's pretty cool. I can also, again, if you've got a big photo library, imagine you've got several years worth of examples. It will actually do a timeline. And you can go through, let me get out of that again. You can actually go through your timeline and see your pictures organized by the dates when they were taken. So here's my pictures from my vacation in 2004. And I can look at my different pictures based on when I took them. So lots of different ways to organize your photos. Again, also we talked about how you can do a book, but you can also create a CD. Maybe I want to do a gift CD.
Okay.
All right.
Wow.
I can choose my pictures that I want to include and check it out. Burn the disc right from within Picasa.
This is really a great program.
It really is. And there's, you know, again, we talked about the kind of common things that you would do with digital photographs. You need to fix red eyes. You need to straighten your pictures. You need to crop and resize your images. Maybe you want to share your images. Maybe you want to create a CD or a slideshow. You can do all those things right from within this free program that comes directly from Google.
And you mentioned iPhoto before. Does this run on a Mac platform?
Nope,
yet?
This is Windows only.
Windows
glad
only?
You brought that up. This
Good
is a Windows
for
only
audience.
For our Mac users. We stick with iPhoto, but for all those people out there with Windows, this is a really great solution that lets them do many of the same kind of things.
Okay, I want to thank everybody for coming to Palm Breeze Cafe today. Thanks, Kim. This is really a nice product.
It is a cool little thing.
And we'll see you next week on Palm Breeze Cafe.